Oh wow, it's raining. What a start. Thank you. rainbow. Rainbow, screenshot. Screenshots. Many people surfing down there today, I wonder. Thank you. see if we can get below the clouds. If it keeps on like this, I will have to turn live weather off. But all my nice presets, when I emptied my community folder, should really have put the weather presets back in, but change the weather. It's a first waypoint. This is Point Lookout, or at least the cape over there is Point Lookout. And if we turn this way, we head towards Brisbane. Thank you. Sound Studios froze again. Rose again. That's just not gonna work, is it? Well, get rid. Get it off. Okay, you can see the Brisbane skyline up sort of there, right in the middle of the view. In the, there. Brisbane. Thank you.
Thank you.
something terrible's happened back there. The autopilot, shall we? Over there. Looks like you can start to see a little bit of outback over there. You know, it looks a little bit kind of yellow, kind of red coloured. Thank you. Hey, two cats! Hey, how long ago did you post that? Hey, yeah. How are you, two cats? I'm alright, yeah, had a bit of a sticky start, like. Just kind of issues, little nav map. That was broken, I don't know if it's a sync connect thing. That was broken, so I've had to turn it off. The ICAO thing, that works perfectly, but the other stuff doesn't really work. Yeah, and then OBS stopped streaming. Always happy, always delighted when people are know stuff I like. So, if I just move a little bit further away from the plane, it's a little bit quieter. So we're just inland from Brisbane. I took off at Gold Coast, flew past the beaches on Surface Paradise, then inland to Brisbane. That's when I was having all my problems. So, like, I don't know. Like, I don't know if it should maybe just kind of, like, try this leg again from scratch some other time. But, nah, maybe I'll just stick at it. There's some lovely views, though. It's a shame that no one was around when I was flying past Surface Paradise. Got it on autopilot. Yeah, exactly. And I've taken screenshots. I love that, like, little reflection in that pond down there. Yeah, just sit back now and enjoy the views. We're heading inland. Exciting. All the way across Australia. So, how's the how's Toowoomba Island going? Yeah, how's the zoo? Have you finished the zoo yet? What's the zoo for? Why is there a zoo on it, by the way? I saw the amount of detail that you're putting into it, so like I can imagine it's going to be a lot of effort to get it finished, but it'll be worth it. It'll be might be approaching Jefferson quality almost, apart from it's come completely out of your head rather than through lots of kind of research about what a real place looks like. Yeah. Look forward to all the fireflies having a fly in there. So I presume that's gonna happen. Man, yeah. egg that now, Megan. We actually had some rain before. I had to turn it off live weather. Maybe have another look and see what live weather looks like now. No. It's an easy enough decision to make. So this is the Dagila National Park, which is, you know, just inland from Brisbane. These lovely forested hills, they're a national park. Dagila. Blend, tomorrow will be some blender work on jobs I need to do. You're pretty good at that blender, I've seen. Are you able to actually create a challenge with the hoops, or is that just going to be for funsies? Or will there be some way of actually measuring people's times? So among the things that's happening, by the way, today, collision versions of them, for the real hardcore, hit one, game over. So like, my stream deck has decided not to work. I don't know if there's issues with SimConnect. I'm wondering if it's because there's that add-on that uses SimConnect. So maybe that's kind of crashed the entire shebang. But I seem to be getting little nav map up no problem now. Didn't at the start. But then OBS dropped. Okay, so on the other side of this, of these mountains, definitely some kind of the bush is out there. And you know, in no time at all, this is now inland Australia. Get all the screenshots. There's me. Sort of me. Doesn't look anything like me, but I'm talking rubbish. Chatting shit. You know what, it's actually been, the views have been a lot better than I thought they would be. Just this area around the mountains. I love the kind of like fairly drastic change in sort of like landscape type here. Gold Coast is really nice, so that's like the fifth largest city in Australia, and it's the largest city that's not a capital city, and it's kind of a city that's strung along the beach. historically it was lots of separate towns, and it's just kind of come together into this huge kind of agglomeration of skyscrapers and beach resorts and surfing. And now we're heading inland to a place called Toowoomba, which is Australia's second largest inland town after Canberra. But you know, we're having a proper fly around first. This leg of the trip is a lot less direct than what the others will be, just because there's things that I wanted to see in this area. Papua New Guinea is a nice place to fly. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, that's kind of like mountain flying and bush flying, kind of like backcountry airstrips and all kind of, you know, like that kind of thing central, isn't it? There's that guy on YouTube, Missionary Bush Pilot, actually flies in there. He takes kids to school, he delivers supplies to isolated villages. So landing on these little kind of strips on a mountainside part of the jungle. So yeah, look at how arid all of this is. And this is, I mean, I'm fairly certain it's a reservoir. It's not going to be a natural lake. There's very few natural lakes in Australia. But also, like, you can usually tell something's a reservoir because it's got this heavily indented shape. Because natural lakes that erode their shoreline over years until the outline of the lake is sort of like a sort of smooth lake shaped thing. But here, because it just filled a valley, there isn't that kind of like erosion. Maybe in like hundreds of years time or something, then these areas where there've been reservoirs will have eroded into a more lake shape. Yeah, so you just end up with it kind of like heavily indented. I'm gonna check, because I might be absolutely talking out my arse here, because it might not be a reservoir at all. Lake Rivenhoe. Oh yeah, there's some dams. Yeah, we're approaching waypoint 2. I can bring the map up actually, if you have a look. So here we are, but where we've been, so we started off down here, Gold Coast, and that's all strung out along the sea. There's lots of skyscrapers, it's a very modern, almost like the Dubai of Australia it looks like. I think the tallest residential building in the southern hemisphere is there. Follow the coast up, this area here is very nice, a lot of kind of lagoons and things like that. Headed inland over Brisbane, looks great in photogrammetry. And then from Brisbane, we then flew over this area, and this is kind of where you joined us. At this point I put autopilot on as well, because I wanted to just sit back and enjoy the views. This is a huge reservoir on the Brisbane River. So this, I guess, must be supplying water for Brisbane. Brisbane's a long way over those hills now. So the place where we're going, Toowoomba. Oh, just Toowoomba. So Toowoomba, it's actually sort of over there. It's on the ridge of those mountains. So it's at a fair altitude. Because those hills over there, the bush actually sort of like darts up there at that altitude. So it's not like a mountain ridge, so you go up and then down to the other side. It's just a shelf, you go up and then that's the altitude, you know, it's plateau on the other side. Yeah, that's where Toowoomba is, but we're flying up here and we're actually going to land at an airport up here as well. It's just very interesting, the things you can see as well. Patterns in the water, changing landscape. In the second episode, we'll be leaving Toowoomba and heading further inland over an area called the Darling Downs. Kind of lots of agricultural centre, kind of rolling hills and stuff. So that'll be interesting to see as well. Yeah, thanks for lurking, Kitfox. Always appreciate stuff like that. I don't think I'll be getting to affiliate anytime soon. Oh look, some boomerang shaped fields. It's a shame, hope it gets better soon. It's a shame he's not streaming tonight, because I won't be able to do tomorrow night, so I'll miss that section of the Hannibal trip. I'd been hoping that I'd kind of be able to do you know, the entirety of one of his adventures, but it is not to be. Just listen to the music. The great thing about Flight Simulator streaming is so much of the time you just don't have to do anything. So here's the town of Toogoolawa. I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly. And that's a little airfield down there. So we're not coming up. Just quite a bit of this sort of landscape. Move the microphone a little bit closer to me. Happened. We're frozen. If this is a... Oh! We're going again. I was about to say, if this is a crash to desktop, I'm just quitting. Fine, we're fine. We'll land and refuel at the next airport. I was debating whether to just fly over it, but we could do with fuel. Jesus, that's painful. 10 nautical miles from Nanango. We're just coming up on 5 nautical miles out, so I am going to bring this into land. The way this stream's gone, I'm definitely going to flip it over. I'm guessing that like little splotches up ahead looks like a town up ahead. That could be Nanango. Coming up on 5 nautical miles, so autopilot is now off. And we want runway 22. Head over to that kind of the town, and then the runway, which is a grass runway, it's beside the road, so maybe the road will help me find the runway, because sometimes those grass runways are a little bit difficult to spot. Thank you. Is that maybe the airfield? It is. It's called Nanango Airport, so even though it's a grass strip, it sounds like it will be a little bit bigger, so that's maybe it, but it's like a long clearing. I guess there might be a runway in there. Well, we know that the main road through the town also is parallel with the runway, so we will just kind of go out this way, find that road and follow it in. Is that the road? I think this may be the road. Okay, so there's the main road. It's darker than all the other roads and a little bit wider. And there's definitely something. Oh, no, it's not that one. That is a runway. Oh, it's obvious now. Maybe need to circle again. So we're a bit close. Ta-da! We are landed. let us refuel and get straight back in the air. Shall we just keep going in the direction we're going? Yeah, I reckon this plane can manage it. Shall we? Oh, I will. Uh-oh. It's okay, it's okay. Bring it up, bring it up, bring it up. Woo! First airport sorted. And just carry on flying in this direction. Stick autopilot back on. It's not off, that's why. It's messed with my trim. Why is it doing that? Autopilot's back on. Off autopilot. Off. On. Off. Okay. Stop messing with my fucking plane. What? We shouldn't be tilting like that. Oh, well, we've reached the altitude we need. Oh well. It's only a short hop to the next waypoint. So the airport is just back there. Something going on there, I wonder if I can find out. Quarry, looks like a quarry. Power station. So we fly over these mountains. So, it's not really that relevant since I've not done the livery that I was going to do, but this would be the area that is the owners of this area. So, like, Australia has two types of land ownership. There's like some Aboriginal land ownership where tribes that originally inhabited and still do inhabit maybe the certain areas are recognised as the traditional owners of that, but that isn't that's a different system to the normal kind of legal system of land ownership that exists. So so I didn't look into what fully the implications are of all of that, but nevertheless the owners of this area are the Aboriginal people who can actually look them up. The Bunya people. Oh yeah, and these are the Bunya Mountains up ahead. They had Bunya. So the Bunya people had some names for stars. I haven't written the names down anywhere, and I can't find where the website was that had them on. But basically, I was going to name the plane after one of the stars, and it would basically be a star that is sort of signifies this direction that we're heading, kind of like east, west, southwest, across Australia towards Perth. It was all going to be really appropriate and everything, and you know, everything was going to be like super relevant and well thought out, but then it takes time to actually do the liveries, and I couldn't find a paint kit for the Kitfox, and I never got time to look into which blender importer work so I could actually make a paint kit and then make a livery. So you know, we're just in a nameless plane, but oh well. Ah, flaps. Oh, so embarrassing. We're going so slow, and I couldn't work out why. Just inland from the coast, from the west east coast of Australia, it's quite mountainous, but as we get to the crest of this mountain, you get a glimpse of Australia's vast, mostly flat interior. And then we will be turning left, and because we're having a bit of a flyabout today, so we're not heading straight into the interior yet. We will turn left and then head down towards Toowoomba, where this leg of the trip will end. Something interesting there. This is Mount Mobulan. Just made it as well. Here's a turn. Now, that area over there is the Darling Downs. I will be flying over that in the next leg. I don't know when that's going to be because I don't really have any sort of schedule. I find it difficult to make a schedule with my life. You know, like various things on different days. There's not a lot of routine. So it's difficult. It's difficult to make routines, but you know, I'll do this. I'll go all the way across Australia, whether anyone watches or not. Hopefully get the occasional visitor. I just need to nip away. Let's see. Because my stream deck's not working, I have to do all of this by on OBS. No. Turn the webcam off for a second and turn the microphone off.
Okay. Right, we're getting close to our destination of Toowoomba now. Want to come into land. It's 15 nautical miles. Right in the Darling Downs, which is the area we're going to fly over next time. We're now flying roughly south, so the sea is over there. Junior Mountains are still visible behind us. Just over 10 nautical miles to go. Nautical miles to go. Seven nautical miles. So Toowoomba is sort of on the edge of the mountains that we could see inland when we were flying along the coast. So So you can just about make out over there, there's a sort of the escarpment, and the town sits right on the edge of that. We're coming up to 5 nautical miles, so let's get behind the cockpit and get this thing landed. Autopilot, you have done your job and you are no longer needed. And we are going to come in on runway 11, so we're going to go over to the right. Look out for what should be a reasonable size of regional airport. I assume that towns of this sort of size in Australia will have decent sized airports, because it's a big country, so a bunch of people are using planes to get about a fair bit. I reckon it's over there, just behind that hill, maybe. So this is the major highway, just kind of down there. Then there's another main road, and again, we can use that other main road. Guide us in. Okay, so there's the highway, and just above the nose there you can see where a main road into town comes off it. And if we follow that road, I can see the runway. That's a nice big runway. That shouldn't present us with any problems whatsoever. We'll come into land and then call an end to this stream. Flaps. And we will soon add the second notch of flaps. Second notch of flaps. Thank you.
flaps off, so you know I can. I put the flaps up as soon as I land to try and keep it from taking off again, because I want to pull back on the stick when I come to brake. Oh no. And the plane really likes to flip over, and it likes to take off again. And it was a bit of a messy landing, but we didn't leave the runway, so let's see if we can pull back. Yeah. I can see a taxiway. Oh, almost. Welcome to Toowoomba, people. The second largest inland settlement in Australia, after Canberra. Still not far from Brisbane, because we flew north a bit to visit the land belonging to the Boonya people for reasons which were going to be to do with the livery that I was going to create for the plane. But and then south again, so we've flown in like a big horseshoe shape. From now on though, it'll be much more direct. I think I actually downloaded a custom scenery for this airport, but I don't have it because, you know, sim update, and therefore emptied the community folder and couldn't find it to put it back in. So move. And there we go. Parking brake on, fuel shut off, battery off, all this stuff off. That was never on. Here we are. I'm just going to pitch my tent here. There'll be some places we stop later on in the adventure where it is much more the case of like landing somewhere that seems in the middle of nowhere and just getting the old tent out. I'm sure the authorities here at Toowoomba Airport won't mind me kipping on the apron at all, but yeah, here we are. Thank you for watching, everyone, and I will see you next time. I'll put an announcement in Murphy's Discord probably when I'm about to do it, but that's us. Had a few issues at the start,
you know, if loads of people show an interest in the next one, I might even redo this whole leg just to have people flying along and watching and stuff. But hey ho, here we are. Good night.